This conference will now be recorded.
Okay. Is my screen is visible? Please let
Not
me
yet.
know once you are able to see.
Yeah, we can see now.
Okay. Okay. So we have seen if else statement, right? Let's see pattern matching. What is a pattern matching? This is important, guys. People will ask in interview. Okay, what is a pattern matching? How it will work? You might have heard about in a C, C++, Java also. There is something called switch case, switch and case, right? Suppose if I have a multiple conditions, what we will do? If else, if we will write. Instead of writing those many if else conditions, we will write one switch case. If that case is matched with respect to case what we provide, then we'll execute only that code. Right? Let me show you the pattern matching. Pattern matching is nothing but if anyone is from the SQL background, case when. We have like a case when, right? Same exactly here. The case when, if you're from any other programming language, like a switch case. Okay, multiple cases we will write. Okay, let me show you a simple demo. I have already, the code is there. Actually, typing the code will take a lot of time. So you can just ignore this one. It's not really required. If I remove this one, it may give some error somewhere, but you can just ignore this. From here, it is start. Match demo. Okay. So look at here. I have a variable called fruit. If this variable matches with the apple, that fruit variable has some value in it. If this value matches with any one of the case, then I'm trying to do some operation on it. It can be just a print, or it can be some operation, some group of operation. It can be just a print, or it can be some group of operation. Okay, let me write for you guys if that is the case. If you are not able to understand in the bigger program, let me write a simple program to make you understand. Everyone, please take note of it. Pattern matching. Pattern match. Demo 2. Oh, I think I already have a demo 1. Pattern match demo. Okay. Go with your main method. Then let's take where I have a fruit. In this fruit, I have taken apple. Okay. What I'm trying to do, if the fruit is apple, I want to do something. If the fruit is orange, I want to do something. If the fruit is something else, mango, I want to do something. So I want to write such kind of pattern matching. I want to write such kind of condition. So if apple do this, if orange do this, if mango do this, instead of writing those many if conditions, we will write simple pattern matching. So how we will write a simple pattern matching? Look at here. Fruit match, not matches, match. Match matches is the regular expression. Matches is, you have something called regular expression, there will be having a pattern matching. That's a different. This is switch case kind of matching. Okay, here if it is match, what I need to do, case if it is apple, do some operation. We'll use the symbol, we'll call rocket symbol. This is called rocket. We'll call them as a rocket. Then you can just print here. For now, I'll show you just a print statement. Next, I'll show you some operation, collection of operations. Similarly, it takes few more cases. Orange. It's mango. Nothing else. Okay, let me change this here also. None of them are matched. There should be something called default, right? There should be something called none of them matched. You just give this. No matching fruit. No matching fruit. Okay. Let me run this program. You'll understand simply. Let me execute this. Not in this program, it's somewhere else. So I didn't complete it, the program. That's the reason. So the problem with IntelliJ, yeah, if it find any issue in other, it'll fail. Okay, I'll just say. Okay, let me put this commented. Okay. And also, let me take this thing. I don't need two, just take one. Enter the fruit. Take here. For now, I'll just comment them. Because I work with the hard coded one, later we'll take from the keyboard. Run this program. So earlier it failed because of another file it has issue, not in this file. Okay. I am Apple. Since I have saved, send them, I have passed the Apple. Suppose let's take comment this one, uncomment this. Comment this instead of readint, we'll say restring read line. Read line. Okay, run this program. It'll ask you to enter the value. Let's say. So I am orange. If you enter orange, it will tell you it's same orange. So here, just a print I'm doing, okay, to make you understand the concept of this switch case or pattern matching. I'm just doing it like this. No, not only this, you can do such kind of operations also. You can keep the block up, block. If you open the curly braces, it means it's a block. You can do a block of statements. You can do a block of statements. Okay. So here what I'm trying to do, if it is apple, I'm just printing 1 to 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm just printing the 1 to 5. Forget about this thing. I'll explain in the coming session. I mean, our coming session after this concept. This is the for loop, looping through the elements. And here 1 to 5 means it'll print 1 to 5. I mean, it will not print, it will loop 1 to 5 and printing here, I'm using print statement here, that's the reason it will print. Otherwise, it's a 1 to 5 times it will loop. loop 5 times. Okay, that we will see. This is clear? Is the concept is clear? This concept is clear. If it's apple, they'll do this. If it's a grape, banana, orange, mangoes, and these things will do. And in this pattern matching, you can also have the different type. No need to be always a strings. It can have a different type. If you send that type, or if you send this 10 here, so it will match. It's a 10 value. And this is the, if you don't enter, if you didn't find any matching. So let me show you this example. So wait, what happened? Okay. No matching fruit. So if none of them is matched, it will print the default one. This you will call as a default, or you can say when you don't match any of the case, you want to print something, you will go with this. What it's trying to do is trying to match with your respective cases. Trying to match with the respective cases. Okay. Are you guys clear? Please make a note quickly. So you're trying to do the match. So if it is match, it'll return the respective operation. If it is not match, it'll directly go with this underscore one. It's kind of placeholder. It'll go to that and it'll. We can call it as a default. You can call it as a default.
It is similar to case statement in SQL, right?
Yes, case statement in other programming languages. Switch, case when in SQL, switch in other programming languages.
Okay.
So we have seen with a variable, right? I mean, we have seen like a simple statements. We can do with the methods also. I'll show you that. We have an example here. If you ever understand, I'll go with the next topic. I mean, next way of pattern matching. This is one way of the pattern matching. Okay, let me show you some real time example how we will use in the real time. Look at here, case, your variable pipeline match. You'll write like if it is a pipeline is batch. You will do these operations. If the pipeline is a self-service, we will do this. This is simple, your switch case. If none of them match, actually here there is no default. If the none of them match, you can just say case underscore and you do that none of them are matched or whatever it is. And you can exit or whatever you can do. Like this. Okay, let me show you the next example. Is everyone is clear about this?
Yeah.
Okay, let's move to the next. Okay. Method one I'll show you in a couple of minutes. Before that, I don't want to match with a value. I want to match with the data type. This is also some kind of conditions, guys. So normally in the previous example, what I did, I exactly matched with the value content. I don't want to match with the content. I don't want to match with the content. I want to match with the data type. I want to match with the data type. How will I match with the data type? Your pattern matching helps that, and switch case does not have that option. I think I think you have to write your own in the case, you have to write your own type that way. Okay, but here you can simply write element match that variable and the respective data type. What do you want to match? If it's making you confused here, let me copy this to. Separately, paste it here. Let me comment the above one. Look at here. What is any? What is any?
Data type of
all the data types.
All the data.
All the data types are all the Scala all the Scala classes. Any is the parent or top level class of all Java, all Scala classes. In Java, object is top, object is the parent of all the normal Java classes, right? Similarly, any is the top. So any means any type, it can be any type, but when it comes to the pattern matching, it comes to the pattern matching. If it is integer, print this stuff. If it is any type, if it is integer type, print this. If it is a float, print this. If it is a double, do this. Here, I have not written the println. I'll tell why. Whatever this match returns, whatever it is, see, in the earlier example, we just done our operation. We are not assigning to anyone. We are not assigning to anyone, but here we are assigning to some variable. What we are assigning, whatever the return value, whatever the return value we are getting from here, whatever the return value we are getting from here, we are assigning to this variable. Then that variable we are printing here, that variable we are printing here. Okay, let me run this program, you'll easily understand. So I have taken 100.0f. Can anyone tell me what is the data type of this? Sorry,
float.
If F is there, float. If D is there, if D is there,
double.
Okay, I'm going to run this program. Return value. Okay, actually, this print statement is printed. Okay, this written. Return value from the match case. Return value from the match case. I am float. Actually, this has been returned. This has been returned. Why it is written? It is not matched with Abhishek. It is not matched with A. It's not matched with a D, S, or something. You can write anything. It's not matched with another. So sorry. So duplicate. You can have a duplicate, but there is only one will get executed. Okay. So it is not matched with the value, right? It's matched with the type. Let's look at here. I'm going to give D. Double. Do you have a double here? Yes, I have a double. Okay. It's not matching with the 100. Earlier it is matched with the value apple. This time it is not matching with the 100 or not matching with the 1000, 10,000. It's not taking care of that. It's not worried about the value. It is we're comparing or we're matching with the data type. We're matching with the data type. So it means that with the help of this pattern matching, not only value, we can also compare the data types. You can also match the data types. If this data type is matched, execute respective operation. If the data type is matched, execute respective operation. That is the meaning of it. This can be anything. It can be FR, it can be D, it can be Vera, it can be your name, whatever it can be. It is no concern about them, so they won't be worried about them. Only worried type, data type. Okay, let me run this time. Double. Here, I'm returning a value. That's the reason I'm storing into other variable. The pattern match can return a value. Pattern match can return a value. Suppose if I pass integer, it will print some information and also it return. In Java or C++, if you want to return any variable or any value, you have to write return. Return like this, you have to write. Here also it will work. Even if you don't write that, the last expression, not the last statement, last expression, the last expression will be considered as written. The last expression will be considered as written. Not to worry, while discussing about methods, we will see that. What is the last expression, how it will written, okay? The last expression is automatically considered as a written, or you can write written explicitly. So it will be very much clear. If I remove this only, what it is, he just declared, nothing is assigned, nothing is, so you may get confused. So if you clearly write like this, so you can easily understand, okay, he's returning. But here I have not written that. Even if you don't write, it will return. You can write it. There's no harm in it. You can write it. Okay, let me execute this. Why it didn't come? Because what are the value written? It didn't reach. The statement also didn't print.
Yeah, before only it is returning.
One second. What happened?
Before only it is returning back. I am float, I am double. That is before only it is
returning. No. One second. This is not a block of statement, right? One second. Not a block of statement or method. This is correct. So if I give integer number here, if I give integer number, one second, guys. It means what is happening, right? When I write return, the cursor is getting returned. The cursor is getting returned. So it is not executing the statement also. It's going, it's not a method, right, to write a return statement. So that was my mistake. So yeah, when you don't write your last statement, when you don't, last expression is, you can just assume that last expression is a return value. In case of methods, you can use the return, or without using return also it will work. But in here, it's a block. So block of statement, even this is also kind of a block of statement, single statement even here. So when you write a block of statement like this, you really no need to write a return statement. The last expression will be considered as a return value from there.
But Ravi, here the case should not match now with the the case is Abhishek here.
So I'm matching with the return type. I'm matching with the return type, data type.
Yeah.
Type matching. That's what I was trying to say. So 1000 is integer. So if that value is matched with integer, float, or double, whichever the data type it match, it is printing that value. Okay.
Here Abhishek is some kind of variable name, isn't it?
It can be a variable name, or it can be a plain text or whatever you can take. So actually it's nothing, it's Abhishek or F or D, S or B, these are all they won't worry about at all. There can be anything.
Okay.
But here the only concern about type, data type. So only about the data type. Okay. Any confusion?
What about ELE? What is that ELE?
This is element.
Element.
This is element. Okay. Element. I'm not normal variable. Sorry, this is one is.
Okay. Okay.
Let's say okay. I'm declaring IN or age. Like this. So what I'm trying to say, when you're in the case, right? When you write like this in the case, it will not try to match with the value. It will not try to match with your value. It will try to match with the data type.
Data type, correct.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, this is also possible. I'm showing this is also possible. If any in any of the requirement comes, you can just go ahead and try that one. We can do that. So far we have seen a single value, right? Single value we have seen. We can do the tuple. Actually, if the value is like this, we can call them as a tuple. We can also match with the tuples. You can also match with the tuple. So 0 and 1. So only match. This case is matched. It will print this one only. One second. This one is done, right? Yeah. Let me show you this one. Not to worry if you're not able to take the make a note of it at this point of time. These programs are there in the GitHub. You guys don't have the GitHub link, right? Let me give the GitHub link. Scala hands-on. And what are the programs we are discussing about? Those programs are there here. Com, Scala. We're discussing first sessions. Go to the first sessions. You can see this. These are the programs we are discussing. If else, match demo. The match demo, this one is we are discussing. This one is we are discussing about. Okay. You can later, you can take this example from here and you can refer or you can write it once again. Okay. So let me give you the path of this. I paste in the chat window. Please make a note of it. And it's very simple. GitHub, Virara Vikumar, Scala Hands-on 710. Or when you say github/viraravi, you can directly land here and you can select which of the project you want to look into. Okay. Please try these programs later, your own. Even though if you already understand, it looks that you know it. It looks that you know it. You will remember for 2 days, 3 days. If you're good in the memorizing things, it may be 1 week. After that, you'll forget. Because they are this terminologies or syntaxes will forget. We may remember the concept, but we'll forget the syntaxes. Okay, so let me comment this one also. Let me execute. This one here, I'm trying to match tuple of values. And let me take one more one. It's not only tuple, even it will work with the conditions also. Here 10 modulo by 2, 9 modulo by 3. It means here the value, what of the remainder will get 0 here, what of the remainder will get 0 here. So it will print 0 comma 0. It will print 0 comma 0, nothing else. So either directly you can pass a value or you can pass an operation. Okay, directly you can pass in the value or you can pass an operation. That's what I want to show you. Let's run this. Sorry. First one match 0, 1. 0, 1 I have passed, so it's printed 0, 1. Second one matched with a 0, 0. That's the reason it's printed 0, 0. Second one match 0, 0. Try to understand the what first we did with the value, second we did with the data type, third we are doing with the tuple. So not only this, we can do with the method also. We can do with the method also. I'll show you that how to do with the method. Any doubts so far? Any doubts so far? Any doubts, any questions?
What is this percentage between this 10 and 2?
This is a modulo operation.
Modulo operation, okay.
Okay, next we will try to do method matching. Method, okay. So This is the method matching. I'm writing my method. Let me comment this again. I don't want to make you confused. That's the reason I'm commenting all of them. I have written this method. Actually, the methods we will write outside the main. If you want to write any method, I know that we have not yet come to the writing of methods, but I'll try to make you understand here. So normally, see, this is your object. Your object start, this is the block start from for the object, and this is the block start for main method. So main method is also one of the method, correct? This is the main method block, and this is the class object block. This main method also one of the methods. So suppose if you are writing any other methods, normally we will prefer to write outside the main method. We have to write outside the main method only, then we will call. Okay, so look at here, this is one main method and this is another method. So syntax of the method, I'll try to make you understand the methods how we will write. We will use the def. Def is defining a method, define and a method name, define and a method name. So it is same as other programming languages. In other programming languages also we will be having a public return type, then method name, then list of arguments. You take any programming language, depends how you write, right? Method name will be there, list of arguments will be there. And before, if it is a programming languages like C++ and Java, you will be having a access modifier, like a public access modifier or private access modifier or a protected access modifier or a default one. Then you will be having a return type, then you will be having a method name, then you will be having the list of parameters in other programming languages. Here also similar kind, but a small change. Okay, you have your define, method name and element. Then element. So no need to be element. I just taken as element. I can take as I, you can take as a B, you can take as X, or whatever you want to take, you can take. Okay. And any, why I'm specifying any, because I want to check with the first, it should be acceptable any data type. Then when I'm comparing here, it should compare with respect to data type. That's the reason I am taking any. If you take int directly here, I really no need to check here the condition. Direct, always it will true int only. It's always true with int only, right? If I take int here, the string cannot be checked out. There is no point checking a string and boolean, right? That's the reason. If I take any, it means there is a possibility. There is a possibility I may get a true, I may get a boolean type, I may get a string type, I may get a any other data types. That's the reason I'm taking any. So don't get confused. Any means it can hold any data type. It can hold any data type. It can hold integer. It can hold. It's the very biggest vessel. So yesterday, day before, we discussed about like vessels, right? Like integer means this much space of amount it will hold. Double means it will take this much. Long means it will take this much. So the capacity, right? So any is the biggest. Any can hold anything. Any is a data type, the parent of all Scala classes. Any is a parent type. So always the parent type can hold child types. Parent type can hold child data types. Okay. It means any is the biggest measurement vessel. So any can hold any type. If you put 2 liters, it will take. If you put 10 liters, it will take. If you put 100 liters, it will take. If you put 1 ton, it will take. So it means it's the biggest. It's a parent. Okay. So that's the reason. If I take integer, it'll take. If I give character, it'll take. If I give string, it'll take. So that's the reason I specified any. Okay. So I have written my method. So method syntax is very simple. Define method name and your variable and return type. This is return type. And this is return type. So we have written unit. Unit means it won't return anything. It won't return anything, but string means it returns a string data type. When I say like this, it returns some return type. And this is for your pattern matching, guys. So it won't be all other methods won't be the same way. All other methods will be different way. But here, this method is only doing a pattern matching. That's the reason I have written equal then element match and all. other method, normal methods will not be looks like this. So see, your main method look like that? No, right? Your main method doesn't look like that. So even other methods also will, it won't be look exactly this syntax. That syntax is different. Till here it is same. Till here it is same. Then you'll start with the curly braces and block of code you'll write. Okay, let me execute this. So now I have written my method. I have written my method. Method with, we have to call that method, right? So why we write the methods whenever or wherever I want to make use of that code, I will call that code by passing the parameters, whatever is required. So I'm going to call it here. I'm going to call it here. Let's say val result equal to type match. I'm passing some value here. Let's say I'm passing some string. Hello. Okay. So whatever the value comes from here, it will return to this. Then I'll print this value. Returned value. Oh, yes. Okay. Yeah, I have purposely written this one. So I don't want to call hell. That's the reason I said hello. Okay. I don't want to call hello. So just I written hello. It's an English work. We can do whatever we want. Okay, let's go ahead and run this program. I'm string because you written hello. You have written hello. You have sent hello. If I send it here, some kind of number. Will say integer. It's integer. Okay. What is this? This println, don't get confused. You have some println here. You have some println here. Sorry. My mouse actually is, why this is moving completely, including case. Bad. Okay, no problem. Let me try. Yeah. Okay. Any doubt? Any doubts? Rishabh, Venkat, Prem, Gauri, Sudhir. Any questions, sir? Okay. If no questions, we'll answer.
Type match, this, the definition of this method is ELE: colon, any. So the parameter would be of any type that will be passing, correct? So if you remember, I have passed the integer, I have passed the string, I have passed double, so I can pass any type. That's the meaning of it. Any, and after this method will run and the return is of a string type, correct? Right, it's actually returning string only, no?
You see, these are all strings, right? These are all strings. They're all strings. That's the reason. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Let me execute next. I hope everyone is clear about the pattern matching. This is more important in interview. People will ask, what is the pattern matching? How will you match it? And when you have a multiple checks, multiple conditions, I want to, let's say I have a case. The case has to be one condition has to be true, then next another condition has to be true, another third condition has to be true. So you can write if in the if condition we have a R, right? R and we try, right? Same here. Whatever the value I pass, X I'm passing, X either 1 or 3 or 5 or 7, I call odd number. Man, you can write it anyway. So to make you understand with the multiple condition, I have done. So you can do it. You can say X modulo by 2. It's not equal to 0. Then you can say odd. But to make understand the people, multiple conditions, how you can write. So that's the reason I have taken this way. You can directly take your, no need to be, I'll take 1, 3, 5, 7. You can take anything. 9 also odd number. If I enter 9, what it will say? 10 it will print. Right? So don't get confused with this. You just understand the concept. Don't see the number. Okay, let me do one thing. I'll try to put it here. I'm writing my own method. This is another method, multi-check condition. So I'm going to comment this line. Why? Because I don't want to make you confused. So here, let's say, okay, I'll say X greater than 35 marks, but I'm taking only one variable. Okay, I'm taking only one variable. I just want to check. When you want to do a multi check, you'll use this pipe operator. If it is an and, you'll take and. So if whatever the X I'm passing, right, if it is 1 or 3 or 5 or 7, it matches with 1, 3, 5, 7. It's matching. What I'm trying to say is match. If it match with 1, it's match with 3, it's match with 5, it's match 7. I'm saying odd numbers. You have entered odd number. If it is matching with the 2, 4, 6, 8, I'm saying even numbers. Okay. So don't ask me 10 is not even number or 12 is not even number. It is even number. So I'm just matching it. Like if you want to match another thing here, you can do like this. That's what I'm trying to say. If you want to multi conditions, do like this. Okay. So when you want to multiple condition check, you use the pipe. If it is R, it's not and. It should be 1 and it should be 3 and it should be 5. No, that time you should not use this condition. Okay. When you want to use the multiple checks or multiple conditions, you will go with this. We'll go with this. And there is one more thing I can show you. If condition also you can write. Okay. Not only this, if condition also you can write. If conditions also you can write. What are the I? If 0 to 9, so it means this I is between the 0 to 9, since I have used contains, okay? 0 to 9, the range is 0 to 9. The I, if it ranges 10 to 19, so you can write if conditions also in your case pattern match. Okay, not only this, you can have a combination. So one is kind of this tuple, one is kind of data type, one is kind of, I mean, this is like a default one. So you can also have this kind of, different type of conditions also you can keep in the case. Okay, so try to execute this program once again. Try to execute these programs once again from your IntelliJ. Then try to analyze, try to understand it. If you get any confusion, if you're not able to follow, please let me know. I'll try to explain the detail. Okay. So any doubts about pattern matching? Any doubts about pattern matching? If no doubts, I'll just take you to another simple concept, which are loops. Any doubts? Okay, no doubts. What is a loop? What What is the loop? Can anyone tell me?
Repeated condition matching.
Okay.
Until
when you
condition
matches. When you want to repeat the set of statements, when you want to repeat set of statements based on some condition, multiple executions, repeated execution, then we'll go with the loop. Repeated execution, then we'll go with the loop. Look at here. First, try to understand for loop. There is a while loop. While loop. Let's try to understand the while loop, because it's easy to make you understand. That's the reason. Okay. Same as the syntax is the same as in other programming languages also. There is no difference here. Okay. Look at here. I'm giving i equal to 0. What I'm trying to do, I want to print a set of statements. I want to print a set of statements. And this set of statements should be printed till the condition is satisfied. Till the condition is satisfied. Okay. What I want to do, till I less than or equal to 10, I want to run these two statements. I want to run these two statements repeatedly. I want to print repeatedly. I want to write. See, here I'm using println. Maybe some other logic, it may be some other business logic. So repeatedly you may need to call them based on the some condition. So here my requirement is run these two conditions repeatedly. Run these two conditions repeatedly. So by default I have taken 0. How it will become 10? How it will become 10? So to make it 10, we have to do the increment. If I don't do this increment, it's always true. I is 0, 0 is less than or equal to 10. It's always true. So if it's always true, what will happen? This loop will be keep on running. This loop will be keep on running. So that's the reason we'll do in the increment here. Okay. First, let me execute this and okay. Other stuff also there, no problem. Let me run this one. Okay. 0. Initially it is 0. I initially 0, then printed 0 and while demo, 1 and while demo, 2 and while demo, 3 and while demo, and so on, 10 and while demo. And this is completed. This is a do while. The next demo it is, so we'll not worry about that. We'll see. You understand till here? It is printed 10 times. These statements I want to repeat it 10 times. So it's printed 10 times. Suppose if I don't have this condition, I mean this increment. This is always true. This is always true. It will be keep on running. There won't be any ending. 0 while demo, 0 while demo, 0 while demo. It's always 0. It will keep on running. There won't be stop. This is called true while loop. True while. It's always true. Infinite loop. It will be running infinite times until you click on this button. Until you stop explicitly, it will be keep on running. Okay. It will keep on running. So make sure that when you write your condition, the condition, sometime the condition should be unsatisfied. Okay. So otherwise it will be always true. If it is always true, there is a possibility infinite times it will go ahead and create. Suppose if you are creating objects, if you are creating objects infinite times, suppose if you are creating objects infinite time, what will happen? Your memory will be blast. It will show memory out of exception. Okay, out of memory exception. Any doubt about the while loop? Any doubt about the while loop? So if you want to make it infinite loop, if you want to make it infinite loop, you can write like this also. Just make it flag true, or you can directly keep true. I can write like this. You directly say true. No flag, nothing. You can just directly say true. Done. This is infinite. It will be print out, keep on printing. It will be keep on printing. It will be keep on printing. Okay. So please make sure that there are some cases we'll go infinite loop. If you see our consumer, Kafka consumer, whoever attended the Kafka sessions, Kafka consumer is infinite because it has to keep on running. It will be keep on running and fetching the records. So that's the reason. That is a there are some scenarios where we will keep infinite times loop. So this is one of the example. Your Kafka consumer should keep on running, then only keep on get the data and it will display in the console, right? That's the reason it was keep on running. So to run the keep on running infinite times, what we will do, we will use a true while or while true. We'll call it infinite loop. Infinite times we'll running the loop. Okay, make sure that you are based on the requirement you'll be using this, otherwise you'll end up with if it's the creation of the objects or the creation of the string, there is a possibility of the memory out of memory out of exception, out of memory exception it may throw. Okay, so far what we did, first we are checking the condition, then if the condition is satisfied, then we are going inside and executing it. Condition, I'm checking the condition, I'm checking the condition, and it's satisfied, then going inside. The condition is not satisfied, I'm coming out, I'm not going inside the loop. If the condition is not satisfied, I'm not going inside, I will just come outside. This is coming outside. So suppose if I want to print some message irrespective of condition is satisfied or not, irrespective of condition satisfied or not, then we will go with the do while. Then we will go with the do while. What do while will do, first it will print the condition, the statements. First it print the statements, then it will check the condition. Then it will check the condition. Look at here. Look at here. While false, it means it never be true. It's always false. It's always false. If I go ahead and run this program, your do will do at least once. Do will execute at least once. I could have said do while. See, at least once. At least once it will execute. First it will do the statement, then it will go and check whether the condition is true or false. So if you have any requirement, even my condition is false, at least once my logic should execute. At least once my logic should execute, then we will go with the do while loop. Then we will go with the do while loop. Okay. So if you want to go with infinite, again, instead of false, you can keep it true. So it's infinite loop. Any questions about the while and do while? Any questions about the while and do while? While and do while. If no questions, we can leave for the day. So that's it for today. And we'll connect in the next session. Next session, we will see for loop. Actually, before I start for loop, I want to start something called collection, not collections, array type things. Why? Because in the loop, I'll show more into looping through the collection. That's the reason. We'll have a next session on Monday only. Okay, no session tomorrow. Okay, this weekend no session. We'll be having next session on Monday. By Monday, I want everyone have thoroughly hands-on till this point. Any questions? Please ask me. Else we can leave for the day.
Ravi, can you show the file path on GitHub once?
It's a GitHub/VeeraRavi/. I have pinged in the chat window. Scala hands 710. So I given Scala hands, I missed an on. Okay. I'll paste in the group. Okay, guys. So that's it for now. So let's connect in the next session Monday. Any questions, please ask me, else we can leave. Venkat, Varsha, Sudhir, Gauri, Rishabh.
Thank you.
No question.
No, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye. Bye.